Okay guys, so now let's begin the session. First question is, what is electronics? Answer is, the study and use of electrical devices that operate by controlling the flow of electrons or other electrically charged particles. Okay, so this is the definition of electronics. Electronics is the study and use of electrical devices that operate by controlling the flow of electrons. Okay, next question, what is the difference between electronics and electrical? This is very important question. Basically, electronics work on DC, means direct current, and with a voltage range of minus 48 volt DC to plus 48 volt DC. If the electronic device is plugged into a standard wall outlet, there will be a transformer inside which will convert the AC voltage you are supplying to the required DC voltage needed by the device. For example, computer, radio, TV, etc. Okay, now electrical. Electric devices use line voltage is 120 volt AC, means alternating current, and 240 volt AC, etc. And electric device can also be designed to operate on DC sources, but will be at DC voltages above 48 volt. For examples are incandescent lights, heaters, fridge, stove, etc. Okay, so this is the difference between electronics and electrical. Next question, what is communication? This is very important question. Communication means transferring a signal from the transmitter which passes through a medium, then the output is obtained at the receiver. And communication says is transferring of message from one place to another. It's also called communication. Next question, different types of communication explain. So there are two types of communication, analog communication and digital communication. As a technology, analog is the process of taking an audio or video signal, the human voice for example, and translating it into electronic pulses. At the other hand, digital is breaking the signal into a binary format where the audio or video data is represented by a series of ones and zeros. As well as digital signals are immune to noise, quality of transmission and reception is good. Component used in digital communication can be produced with high precision, and power consumption is also very less when compared with analog signals. Okay, next question, what is latch-up? Latch-up is very important topic in electronics. So latch-up pertains to a failure mechanism wherein a parasitic thyristor, such as a parasitic silicon controlled rectifier or SCR, is inadvertently created within a circuit, causing a high amount of current to continuously flow through it once it's accidentally triggered or turned on. Depending on the circuit involved, the amount of current flow produced by this mechanism can be large enough to result in permanent destruction of the device due to electrical overstress. And this is EOS. Okay. Next question, what is diode? Answer is, in electronics, a diode is a two-terminal device. Diode have two active electrodes between which the signal of interest may flow, and most are used for their undirectional current property. Okay. Next question, what is transistor? Answer is, in electronics, a transistor is a semiconductor device commonly used to amplify or switch electronic signals. The transistor is a fundamental building block of computers and all other modern electronic devices. Some transistors are packaged individually, but most are found in integrated circuits. Okay. Next question, what is sampling? Answer is, the process of obtaining a set of samples from a continuous function of time x of t, okay, is referred to as sampling. Next question, state sampling theorem. This is very important question. Sampling theorem states that while taking the samples of a continuous signals, it has to be taken care that the sampling rate is equal to or greater than twice the cutoff frequency, and the minimum sampling rate is known as the Nyquist rate, and it's denoted by N. Okay. Next question. What are the advantages of registers? Answer is, first advantages of registers is, registers are very small in size. It's very small. Okay. And it's very easy to carry registers from one place to another place. And registers are very cheap. Okay. So they all are the advantages of registers. Next question. What is the principle of microwave? This is also very important question. So answer is, microwave essentially means very short wave. Okay. As you know, as the name suggests, microwave means very short wave. The microwave frequency spectrum is usually takes to extend from 1 GHz to 30 GHz. The main reason why we have to go in for microwave frequency for communication is that lower frequency band are congested and demand for point-to-point communication continue to increase. The propagation of the microwave takes place in space wave, in V means volt. Okay. Next question. What is cutoff frequency? So, the frequency at which the response in minus 3 dB with respect to the maximum response. It's known as cutoff frequency. Okay. Next question. What is passband? Answer is, passband is the range of frequencies or wavelengths that can pass through a filter without being attenuated. Okay. Attenuated means without being any loss. Okay. Next question. What is a stop band? Answer is, a stop band is a band of frequencies between specified limits in which a circuit such as a filter or telephone circuit does not let signals through, or the attenuation is above the required stop band attenuation label. Okay. Next question. Define power rating. Answer is, the power rating of a diode is defined as the maximum value of power that can be dissipated without failure if volt F is the forward bias voltage and IF is the forward bias current. I denotes by current. Okay. So PD, power rating, is equal to BF multiplication IF. Okay. Next question. What is rheostat? Answer is, rheostat is a type of variable resistor which is used to control the flow of electric current by manually increasing or decreasing its resistance. Next question. What is demodulation? Answer is, demodulation is the act of removing the modulation from an analog signal to get the original baseband signal back. Demodulating is necessary because the receiver system receives a modulated signal with specific characteristics and it needs to turn it to baseband. Okay. Next question. Explain radio environment in building. Answer is, so firstly I am talking about building penetration. Building penetration depends on the material used for construction and architecture used in building. Okay, the barriers building to building and is based on building construction. Next one is building height effect. This is, the signal strength is always higher at top floor and generally floor gain higher is about 2.7 dB per floor, which is not dependent on building construction. Next one is building floor reception. In this, the signal isolation between floors in a multi-floor building is on the average about 20 dB. Within a floor of 150 into 150 feet, the propagation loss due to interior walls, depending on the wall material, is about 20 dB between the strong and the weak areas. Okay. Next question. What is resistor? Answer is, a resistor is a two-terminal electronic component that opposes an electric current by producing a voltage drop between its terminal in proportion to the current. That is in accordance with Ohm's law, jo aap bachpan se padhte aa rahe hain. This is V is equal to IR. Okay. Next question. What is inductor? Answer is, inductor is a passive electrical device employed in electrical circuits for its property of inductance. An inductor can take many forms. Okay. Next question. What is conductor? Conductor is a substance, body, or device that readily conducts heat, electricity, sounds, etc. Okay. And copper is a good conductor of electricity. Okay. Next question. What is a semiconductor? Answer is, a semiconductor is a solid material that has electrical conductivity in between that of a conductor and that of an insulator. Means, an insulator is a material that resists the flow of electric current. It's an object intended to support or separate electrical conductors without passing current through itself. It can vary over that wide range either permanently or dynamically. Next question. Name the modulation techniques. So, for analog modulation, techniques are AM, SSB, FM, PM and SM. And techniques for digital modulation, they are OOK, FSK, ASK, PSK, QAM, MSK, CPM, PPM, TCM, OFDM. Okay guys, आप इन सब के फुल फॉर्म कमेंट बॉक्स में मेंशन कीजिएगा, फ्रेंड्स के साथ शेयर कीजिएगा एंड अगर आपको किसी में भी कोई प्रॉब्लम होगी तो आप कमेंट कर दीजिएगा, मैं आपको कमेंट में जो भी फुल फॉर्म आपको नहीं समझ में आएगी अच्छे से एक्सप्लेन कर दूंगी. ओके, सो दिस इज क्वेश्चन इज फॉर यू ऑल, काइंडली सॉल्व इट. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, एक्सप्लेन AM एंड FM. व्हाट इज AM? AM स्टैंड्स फॉर एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन. Amplitude modulation is a type of modulation where the amplitude of the carrier signal is varied in accordance with the information bearing signal. Okay. And second one is FM. FM stands for frequency modulation. Frequency modulation is a type of modulation where the frequency of the carrier signal is varied in accordance with the information bearing signal. Okay. Next question. Explain RF. So, firstly, RF stands for radio frequency. Radio frequency is a frequency or rate of oscillation within the range of about 3 Hz to 300 GHz. This range corresponds to frequency of alternating current electrical signals used to produce and detect radio waves. Since most of this range is beyond the vibration rate that most mechanical systems can respond to, and RF usually refers to oscillations in electrical circuit or electromagnetic radiation. Okay. Next question. What is modulation and where it's utilized? This is very important question and frequently asked question in electronics interviews. Okay. So, modulation is the process of varying some characteristics of a periodic wave within external signals. Radio communication superimposes the information bearing signal onto a carrier signal. This high frequency carrier signal can be transmitted over the air easily and are capable of traveling long distance. And the characteristics are amplitude, frequency or phases of the carrier signal are varied in accordance with the information bearing signal. As well as modulation is utilized to send an information bearing signal over long distances. Okay. Next question. Where do we use AM and FM? So, AM is used for video signals, for example, TV. And its range from 535 to 1705 kHz. Okay. And FM is used for audio signals, for example, radio. Range for FM is from 88 to 108 megahertz. Okay. Next question. What is base station? Answer is, base station is a radio receiver transmitter that serves as the hub of the local wireless network and may also be the gateway between a wired network and the wireless network. Okay. Next question. What are the parts of network management system? Network management system, it's also called as NMS. So, following are the parts of network management system. First one OMC, second one NMC, third one OSS. Okay, so what is OMC? OMC stands for Operation and Maintenance Center. It's Computerized Monitoring Center. Next one NMC, Network Management Center. It's centralized control of a network. Next one OSS means Operation and Support System. It's used for supporting activities performed in an OMC and or NMC. Okay. Next question. How many satellites are required to cover the Earth? Answer is 3 satellites are required to cover the entire Earth, which is placed at 120 degrees to each other. The lifespan of the satellite is about 15 years. And this is very important question. Next question. What are GPRS services? Answer is GPRS services are defined to fall in one of the two categories. First one PTP and second one PTM. PTP stands for point to point and PTM stands for point to multipoint. Some of the GPRS services are not likely to be provided by network operators during early deployment of GPRS due in part to the phased development of standard and market demand and another factor affecting the decision of operators regarding which services offer fast. Okay, next question. What is a repeater? Answer is a repeater is an electronic device that receives a signal and retransmits it at a higher level or higher power or onto the other side of an obstruction, so that the signal can cover longer distances without degradation. Next question. What is an amplifier? Answer is an electronic device or electrical circuit that is used to boost, amplify the power, voltage or current of an applied signal is called amplifier. Okay. Next question. Example of negative feedback and positive feedback. So answer is example for negative feedback is negative amplifiers and for positive feedback is oscillators. Okay. Next question. How can a pseudo random noise code be usable? This is very important question from pseudo random noise code. Answer is to be usable for direct sequence spreading, a PN code must meet the following conditions. The conditions are very important. Listen to me very carefully. First condition is sequence must be built from two labeled numbers. Okay. Second condition is codes must have sharp autocorrelation peak to enable code synchronization. Third condition is codes must have a low cross correlation value. The lower it is, more are the number of users which can be allowed in the system. Next condition is the codes should be balanced, that is the difference between ones and zeros in code may only be one. Okay. Now next question, what is oscillator? Answer is an oscillator is a circuit that creates a waveform output from a direct current input. The two main types of oscillator are harmonic and relaxation. The harmonic oscillators have smooth curved waveforms, while relaxation oscillators have waveforms with sharp changes. Okay. Next question. What is an integrated circuit? Answer is an integrated circuit means IC, also called a microchip, is an electronic circuit eats onto a silicon chip. The main advantages are low cost, low power, high performance and very small in size. Okay. Next question. What is handover and what are its types? Answer is handover in mobile communication refers to the process of transferring a call from one network cell to another without breaking the call. There are two types of handover which are as follows. First one hard handoff and second one soft handoff. What is hard handoff? So hard handoff is the process in which the cell connection is disconnected from the previous cell before it's made with the new one. And second one, soft handoff. It's a process in which a new connection is established first before disconnecting the old one. It's thus more efficient and be smart and smart also. Okay. Next question, what is crosstalk? Answer is, crosstalk is a form of interference caused by signals in nearby conductors. The most common example is hearing an unwanted conversations on the telephone. So crosstalk can also occur in radios, televisions, networking equipment, and even electric guitars. Okay, next question, what is op-amp? Op-amp stands for operational amplifier. Okay, and it's often called an op-amp. It's a DC coupled high gain electronic voltage amplifier with differential inputs and usually a single output. Typically, the output of the op-amp is controlled either by negative feedback, which largely determines the magnitude of its output voltage gain, or by positive feedback, which facilitates regenerative gain and oscillation. Okay. Next question, explain Bluetooth. Answer is, Bluetooth is a design to be a personal area network where participating entities are mobile and require sporadic communication with others. It's omnidirectional, that is, it does not have line of sight limitation like infrared does. Ericsson started to work on Bluetooth and named it after the Danish king Harold Bluetooth. As well as, Bluetooth operates in the 2.4 GHz area of spectrum and provides a range of 10 meters. It offers transfer speeds of around 720 kbps. Okay. Next question. What is a feedback? Answer is, feedback is a process whereby some proportion of the output signal of a system is passed, means feedback, to the input. This is often used to control the dynamic behavior of the system. Next question. What is CDMA, TDMA and FDMA? They are very important topics in electronics. Answer is, CDMA stands for code division multiple access and is a channel access method utilized by various radio communication technologies. CDMA employs spread spectrum technology and a special coding scheme where each transmitter is assigned a code to allow multiple users to be multiplexed over the same physical channel. By contrast, time division multiple access, TDMA, divides access by time, while frequency division multiple access, means FDMA, divides it by frequency. Okay. Now, an analogy to the problem of multiple access in a room is a channel. Means channel in which people wish to communicate with each other. To avoid confusion, people could take turns speaking, means time division. Speak at different pitches, means frequency division. Or speak in different directions, it means spatial division. In CDMA, they would speak different languages. People speaking the same language can understand each other, but not other people. Similarly, in radio CDMA, each group of users is given a shared code. Many codes occupy the same channel, but only users associated with a particular code can understand each other. Okay, so this is an example of CDMA and TDMA and FDMA. Okay, now next question. Explain different types of feedback. Answer is, there are three types of feedback. First one, negative feedback. Second one, bipolar feedback, and third one, positive feedback. Okay, so what is negative feedback? This tends to reduce output, but in amplifiers, it stabilizes and linearizes operation. Negative feedback feeds part of a system's output inverted into the system's input, generally with the result that fluctuations are attenuated. Okay, now positive feedback. positive feedback, this tends to increase output. As well as positive feedback sometimes referred to as cumulative causation. It's a feedback loop system in which the system responds to perturbation means what is perturbation? A perturbation means a system is an alternation of function induced by external or internal mechanism. Okay, in the same directions as the perturbation. In contrast, a system that responds to the perturbation in the opposite direction is called a negative feedback system. Okay, third one is bipolar feedback, and which can either increase or decrease output. Okay.